Good evening. I'd like to welcome you to the 2022 Fayette Christian School graduation. This time we're going to be led in the pledges by Xander Ivey. Remain standing for that, as well as for the invocation by Pastor Guerin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for his kingdom and stance, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again, with life and liberty for all who believe. Pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Again, I'd like to welcome you. I only have to pray, but I need to say a couple of things of how much I appreciate this group of seniors. They have done much in their school years here at Fayette Christian School, and I just want to say before I pray, I commend each and every one of you. You've done well. My goal for you is to go and serve the Lord with gladness and with truth. May the Lord bless you. Shall we pray? Our gracious Heavenly Father, I thank you for who you are. I thank you that you, in your sovereignty, have built your church. And in building your church, you have given us the opportunity to have a Christian school, to train young people as a discipleship program so that our young people would go forth and serve you. Lord, may we do a better job at that. But may our young people go forth from this place realizing that there's a God in heaven that loves them, that seeks their service for their benefit. Lord, we thank you for our parents and those that have come to watch this graduation tonight. Lord, may they see in these young people, in this program, that you are all and in all. We thank you for this time. Bless now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated.
Today I'll be reading a scripture, Ecclesiastes 12. Remember also your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come, and the years draw near of which you will say, I have no pleasure in them. Before the sun and the light and the moon and the stars are darkened, and the clouds are turned after rain. All the days when the keepers of the house tremble, and the strong men are bent, and the grinder ceases. Because they are few, and those who many look through windows are dimmed, and the doors on the streets are shut. When the sounds of the grinding is low, one rises up to the sound of a bird. All the daughters are songs of bright and low, brought low. They are afraid also of what is high and tremors. All are in the way. The almond tree blossoms. The grasshopper drags itself along, and desires fails. Because man is going to his eternal home, and the monsieur goes about the streets before the silver cord has snapped, or the golden bowl is broken, or the pitcher is shattered at the fountain, or the wheel is broken at the stern, and the dust returns to the earth as it was. The spirit returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, says the preacher, all is vanity. Besides being wise, the preacher also taught the people knowledge, weighing and studying and arranging many proverbs with care. The preacher sought to find words of delight and uprighty. He wrote the words of truth. The words of wise are like goals, and the nails firmly fixed are the collection sayings They are given by one shepherd. My son, beware of any beyond these. Of many making books, there is no end, and much study is weariness of the flesh. This is the end of all matter. All has been heard. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God will bring every deed to judgment, and with secret things, whether good or evil.
Let's stand together. You'll find the words to Be Thou My Vision on the back of your program, and we'll sing through that together. Raise our voices in praise to God.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart, not be all else to me save that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night, waking or sleeping, thy presence my light. Be thou my wisdom, and thou my true word. I ever with thee, and thou with me, Lord. Thou my great Father, I thy true Son. Thou in me dwelling, and I with thee one. Riches I heed not, nor man's empty praise. Thou mine inheritance, now and always. Thou and thou only, first in my heart. High King of heaven, my treasure thou art. High King of heaven, my victory won. May I reach heaven's joys, O bright heaven's son. Heart of my own heart, whatever befall, still be my vision, O ruler of all.
You may be seated.
My pleasure to introduce to you this evening our salutatorian, Miss Emily Barker. She's attended Fayette Christian School since kindergarten and has been very active in extracurricular activities throughout her high school years, participating both in basketball and debate, general knowledge quiz team, choir, and drama. Additionally, she has been involved in out-of-school activities, including a traveling softball team, and as a member of the 4-H and Madison County Junior Fair Board. This fall, Emily will be attending Waynesburg University to pursue a bachelor's degree in criminal justice. She then plans to attend law school with the intent of becoming a prosecutor. So you have been warned. We're very happy for Emily, and she's going to come at this time and give us her salutatorian speech.
Good evening, family, friends, classmates, teachers, and administration. Thank you all for being in attendance of the 2022 Fayette Christian School graduation ceremony. It is my honor and privilege to be the salutatorian of this class of 2022. We are present this evening to celebrate the end of a chapter of our lives. We have walked through many challenges and rejoiced through many achievements together as a class over the last several years. We have run the race of high school, and we have now reached the finish line. We have come a great distance and learned much along the way. Many have come along beside us to teach, influence, and encourage us in ways we never knew we needed. I would like to express my gratitude to the amazing staff and administration here at Fayette Christian. I've attended this school for 13 years, and I owe a great deal of thanks to every teacher and staff member who has taken the time to help me grow in biblical and academic knowledge. Thank you all for spending countless hours teaching me, grading my papers, proofreading my essays, answering my questions, and having insightful discussions with me. You have all impacted my life in ways that you could never imagine. I would also like to thank my classmates. Together, we have laughed at our own ridiculous jokes, talked about anything and everything, annoyed all of our teachers, and even cried over elapsed time. We have been through many difficulties and celebrations, and we have all grown together. Now, finally, we will all graduate together. You have all influenced my life in various ways, and you have been great sources of encouragement. Thank you, Megan, Madison, Xander, Caitlin, McKenna, and Jackson, for all the memories. I am truly blessed to call you my friends and classmates. Finally, I would like to thank my parents and my family. You have believed in me throughout every season of my life. You are my support system, my fan base, and my best friends. You have all done more for me than I may ever know, and you have always loved me unconditionally. Mom and Dad, you have pushed me to be the best version of myself, provided me with everything I've ever needed, and selflessly worked to make my dreams and aspirations a reality. I can say with the utmost certainty that I would not be the person I am without you. You, my family, deserve the highest of praise and my deepest gratitude because you are here with me tonight, just as you have been there for me in every moment of my life. When I was in seventh grade, the girls' basketball coach instructed our team to write one of our favorite verses on an index card and trade verses with someone else on the team. He then required us to memorize the verse we were given and read it aloud in front of our teammates. At the time, I viewed this as a dreaded and mundane task. However, that moment had a long-term effect on my life. The verse I received was chosen by Lizzie Guerin, a senior that year, and it has become a foundational principle in my personal faith. I believe this verse, 1 Corinthians 15:10, is an appropriate reference for this evening. It states, "But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me." Tonight, as I give this speech and graduate alongside my friends and classmates, I am reminded that it is by the grace of God that we are here. We have worked hard and earned our diplomas, but it is by God's grace that we have succeeded. I hope we have made a positive impact on those who will come after us, much like Lizzie impacted me. I pray that our time here was not in vain. I can hear Pastor Guerin's words echoing in my mind. To whom much is given, much shall be required. We have been given much, including a great purpose in this life, and now much is required from us. As we leave here this evening and step into our futures, we must remember that no matter how hard we work, it is by God's grace that we will become who we were always meant to be. I will leave you tonight with one of my favorite quotes from evangelist Christine Kane. God has plucked you out of eternity, positioned you in time, and given you gifts and talents to serve him in this generation. Your race is now. This is your time in history. I pray that we, the Fayette Christian School graduating class of 2022, follow God's will for our lives and always remember that we have been given a great purpose. It is now our time in history. Thank you for being present this evening. May God bless you all.
Thank you, ensemble. This time, it's my pleasure to introduce to us the valedictorian for 2022, Miss Megan Sheeter. Megan has attended FCS longer than any other senior, having started here in pre-kindergarten. She has participated in drama, tone chimes, choir, and both the general knowledge and Bible knowledge quiz teams that compete every year at the BCSO competition. She has also played on the volleyball and basketball teams. This fall, Megan plans to major in pharmaceutical sciences at Cedarville University. She has received the President's Scholarship and other scholarships as well. Megan, we're glad to recognize you this evening as our valedictorian of the senior class. If you'll come now and give us your speech.
Good evening, Pastor Gammon, Pastor Kahn, Mr. Fitch, faculty, staff, family, and friends. Thank you all for joining us this evening. Obviously, Fayette Christian School has had a tremendous impact on our lives. In fact, some of my earliest memories include Pastor whistling down the hallway with his coffee cup in hand and Ms. Hook teaching us sign language in preschool. Fayette Christian School and Fayette Bible Church have been foundations for my academic and spiritual development. Through the faculty, staff, volunteers at FCS, my fellow graduates and I are prepared with the knowledge and ability for this next chapter in our lives. However, maybe more important than the lessons we learned are the people we learned them from. Everyone here tonight has had an impact on my life in their own unique way. Thank you, Mr. Fitch, Mr. Ernst, Mr. Richmond, Mrs. Pontius, and Mrs. Gammon for your dedication and service. I would like to take this opportunity to recognize a few special people. I do not even know where to begin with Pastor Gammon. He is such a vital part of this church and school. His love of God and of people shines through all that he does. Through his actions, I have learned to do all things wholeheartedly and cheerfully for God's glory. Mrs. Miller has played many roles at FCS. She has been a librarian, a history teacher, and a secretary, but more importantly, a mentor and a role model. I have won kindness and compassion from her daily example. Although Mrs. Fitch came here my seventh grade year, I feel like I have known her for much longer. She is multi-talented in many different areas, using them all to glorify God and help others. Mrs. Fitch has taught me to step outside of my comfort zone and try new things. Through dissecting a mink, playing tone chimes, and acting in the play, I have learned to be curious and courageous in all aspects of life. Next, I want to thank my family. I obviously would not be here tonight without them. They are my biggest supporters and my greatest encouragement. I have learned the value of hard work, humility, and bravery through their own lives. Thank you, Amy, Sam, and Grace, for showing me the ropes of life. Thank you, Dad, for instilling in me the need to seek God before all else and to do my best in all that I do for His glory. Thank you, Mom, for your patience in all of my rambling, our nightly Gilmore Girls bin sessions, and for never failing to make me laugh. I will never be able to express my gratitude for God handpicking you to be my mother and for showing me what unwavering love looks like. Finally, I want to acknowledge my fellow graduates. Emily, Madison, and I have been together from the beginning. In fact, we graduated from kindergarten together, although our caps and gowns were much smaller. Along the way, we gained Xander, Kate, McKenna, and Jackson. I love our close-knit, family-like class and the memories we have together. You all are truly some of my favorite people. Throughout the journey, we have learned together, and we have also learned from each other. Unfortunately, Mrs. Gammon, we still do not understand elapsed time. Although we did learn how not to get stuck in a baby swing. Xander. However, the class of 2022 has taught me important life lessons. During our time together, I have learned how to work efficiently with others to reach a goal while also enjoying the process. I think back with fondness on Friday pizza lunches, volunteering at the Samaritan's Purse office, and serving at One Bistro, creating great lifelong memories. My classmates have also taught me to cherish the relationships and friendships God has given me. I will be forever grateful for the laughs, the tears, the ups and the downs I have experienced with these six people. In conclusion, I want to challenge myself and all of you to never stop learning from the people God has placed and will place in our lives. God has given each one of us opportunities to learn and teach one another. As Hebrews 10:24 says, let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds. Thank you.
Upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name. Keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours, and you are mine. Oh.
Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign
is over me, for you are for us, you are not against us. Champion of heaven, you made a way for all to enter in.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever
take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
You make me brave.
Spirit, lead
you
me
make
where
me
my
brave.
Trust is without board.
You call me
out beyond the shore into the waves. You make me brave. You make me brave. No. Call upon
this time, I'd like to recognize Madison Riley, who will come and present the class gift.
Mr. Fitch, on behalf of the senior class, it is my privilege to present to you our class gift. We will be purchasing new chairs for the science lab and a trophy case to be placed in the school entryway.
Thank you, Madison. That's a wonderful gift. Thank you, senior class. Those are both things that can certainly be put to use by all the students. This year I was lamenting the fact that we didn't have a trophy case in the school building. We have trophy cases over here, but they're not often seen, and Laura was very good to us this year, and we had quite a number of trophies we could have filled it this year. So we look forward to both of those gifts, senior class. Thank you very much. All right, this time it's high school choir. learn a lot about folks from pictures, can't you? That was good. Thank you for that presentation. Mr. Ernst worked on that and put that together, and appreciate his efforts and extra hours to do that. Our commencement speaker this evening needs an introduction, to me at least, but I'm going to give you one anyway, all right? Our speaker has spent the past 41 years in pastoral ministry. After completing his undergraduate and beginning his master's degree in 1981, he began serving on the pastoral staff of Calvary Baptist Church in Midland, Michigan. However, I will tell you, you can like this guy because he's not a native there. He's from Philadelphia. Maybe that makes it worse. I don't know. But anyway, we like him in spite of that. During that time, he earned a doctorate of sacred ministries. Since 2003, he has pastored Cross Lanes Bible Church near Charleston, West Virginia. Cross Lanes Christian School, which is a ministry of the church there, has been in existence for almost 50 years. And that is where our speaker and I crossed paths. My wife and I taught there for a year and became West Virginians. We have West Virginians here tonight? Yay, okay, come on. Be more enthusiastic, Coach. Okay, all right. Pastor Dave has been happily married to his wife, Jean, for 42 years, and the Lord has blessed them with three married children and six grandchildren. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you, you tonight's commencement speaker, Dr. David Buckley.
Well, which is worse, that I used to live in Michigan or now I'm in West Virginia? I couldn't tell what was the worst part about that introduction. I will say, I've got to admit, the Buckeyes have had our number in football for many, many years until last November. And then it changed, and I don't know how long it's going to be that way, but it's just a blessing to be here tonight. And thank you for accepting me with all my baggage and everything. It's so good to be here. What a wonderful blessing to be a part of this ministry tonight. I thoroughly enjoyed those speeches, excellent speeches, the music, everything about this night has been just a blessing. And so I'm so thankful to be here tonight. And thank you for that kind, semi-kind introduction. Appreciate that. Pastor Guerin, thank you so much for allowing me to come. And also good to meet Pastor Michael tonight. And I've heard a lot of good things about this ministry, but my first time here, and so it's a blessing to be here. Class of 2022, I want to congratulate you. You've worked hard. You have put in the time and the effort, and I'm excited for the Fayette Christian School Class of 2022 and what the future holds for you. I believe that as you follow the Lord, as you walk in His way, that He's going to bless you in a wonderful, wonderful way. Betty was graduating from high school in just 2 days. And she went to her parents and she asked, "What are you giving me as a graduation gift?" Her dad said, "Betty, don't worry about that. On graduation morning, there will be a gift in the driveway that goes from 0 to 200 in less than 6 seconds. Well, Betty got pretty excited about that, and in fact, she didn't sleep the whole night before graduation. She was dreaming of a brand new bright red sports car. And so early the morning of graduation, she got up, she put her bathrobe on, she ran out into that driveway, and in the driveway there was a gift with a ribbon on top that went from 0 to 206 seconds, a bathroom scale. So, graduates, I hope you don't get a gift like that. I really don't. Well, I want to also congratulate tonight the staff. Where are the staff? Those who are teachers and staff here. I know you work hard. Thank you for all the effort that you have put in to these graduates tonight. Family and friends, what a special occasion. And just a brief word to the parents. Where are the parents at? Let me see your hands. Congratulations, parents. Congratulations. My wife, Jeannie, who's over here, we did this three different times for high school graduation. And every time was special. Every time unique. And every time we had tears in our eyes, tears of joy. And so, parents, you have worked so hard. You have sacrificed so much so that those you love with all your heart, your children, can come to this place tonight and graduate from high school. So I congratulate all of you on this wonderful, wonderful occasion. Containers often do not reflect the value of the treasure inside. I have here a pot. It's a pot that a plant would be put in to grow. And I know it's not much to look at. It's pretty plain. It's not a fancy container. But you know what? The Apostle Paul wasn't much of a container either. Physical appearance, it was mocked. His speaking ability was criticized. In his closet, he had lots of skeletons from persecuting Christians. And yet, Paul was entrusted with a valuable, valuable treasure. A valuable treasure. He summarized his ministry in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 through 6. And he says in those verses that his ministry is one that he has received mercy. He talks about the fact that God has given him the gospel to make clear to those who have not heard the gospel. And he says, we don't preach ourselves, but we preach the Lord Jesus Christ. And then he comes to verse 7 of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, and he says this, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels. We have this treasure in earthen vessels that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. Earthen vessels. What's an earthen vessel? Well, the Greek word ostrakonos means literally hard baked dirt. But it also can mean jars of clay or a clay pot. This is an earthen vessel. And the Apostle Paul says there's a treasure in earthen vessels. This may not look like it's very much, and it isn't. It's pretty plain. And graduates tonight, we all have, every one of us, our earthen vessel, what people see on the outside, who we are when people look at us and see us. And yet Paul said we have a treasure in earthen vessels. A treasure. What is that treasure? For the Christian, for the believer in Jesus Christ, that treasure is the gospel. That treasure is the presence of Jesus Christ within us. It is Christ in us, the hope of glory. And so tonight, I want to take just a few moments, and I won't be long, to talk to you, seniors, and the rest of you can listen in. But I want to talk to you about clay pots. That's the title of my message, clay pots. And I want to share four truths about clay pots as you graduate tonight and go out into life. Truth number one is this. A clay pot finds its value in the treasure it contains. A clay pot finds its value in the treasure it contains. You see, earthen vessels were used for honorable and dishonorable tasks. What were the honorable tasks? Well, you could take a clay pot, and in those days, you could leave your home, go down to the well, and put water in it. And bring that cold water back to your house, and you could drink that water and enjoy it. Sometimes clay pots were used for coins to keep the family money, the coins in. Those were honorable purposes. But also a clay pot can be used for that which is dishonorable, for garbage, even at times in those days for human waste. In 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 20, the Bible says, but in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. You see, graduates, what is stored inside this clay pot is the key to its value. It's not what's on the outside, it's what's stored in this clay pot. And class of 2022, I want you to know tonight that you are very valuable. You are very, very valuable vessels. You've been created in God's image. You've been redeemed by the precious blood of Christ. And you carry within you the love of Jesus Christ, the power of Christ, and his spirit within you. Secondly, truth number two, a clay pot is only valuable if usable. It's only valuable if usable. The container to be usable must be clean. It must be empty. And it must be available for use in order to have value. You know, a pot might be very beautiful on the outside. It might be ornate. I could have brought tonight a pot that had beautiful flowers painted on it and looks so beautiful. But you know what? That's not where the usefulness comes in. It's valuable if it is usable. In 2 Timothy 2:21, the Bible says, therefore, if anyone cleanses himself of these, what is these? The wood, the hay, the stubble. He will be a vessel for honor, sanctified and useful for the master, prepared for every good work. You see, graduates, when the Bible was written, the intellectuals were in Rome, and they were in Greece, and they were in Egypt. But you know what? When God gave us his word, he passed over Socrates. He passed over Aristotle. And instead, our sovereign God gave his message, his gospel, his treasure to farmers and fishermen. People like Peter and Andrew, his brother, James and John, those that followed the Lord Jesus faithfully, they were the clay pots in Jesus' life. They were the clay pots of their day. They weren't fancy, but they were usable. They were usable. And graduates, I challenge you tonight, being usable is more important than beauty. It's more important than brains. It's more important than brawn. It's more important than a lot of bucks in your pocket, a lot of money. I challenge you tonight, graduates, stay tender. I appreciated the speeches, and I could tell in the singing, we've got some young people here with tender hearts. You can't put a price on that. Stay tender before the Lord and usable, because that's where your great, great value will be. Truth number three, a clay pot is valuable when used for the owner's purposes. A clay pot is valuable when used for the owner's purposes. Each of you, graduates, each of you were created special by God. You were created special by God. Everybody in this room was created special by God. It says in Psalm 139:14, we are fearfully and wonderfully made by our Creator God. We were created in the womb, and we are a chosen vessel in the womb as God created us in a wonderful way. In Acts 9:15, the Apostle Paul, it is said, was a chosen vessel, a chosen pot, a clay pot, to bear the name of Jesus before Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. Graduates, God has a unique purpose for your life. I don't know what that purpose is. You don't totally know that purpose yet. But God made you special, and he has a unique purpose for each of our lives. We're different. Not one person in this room is exactly like anybody else in this room. We're different, and your administrator is really different, okay? He's really different, but we're all different. But you know what? We're equally valuable in the sight of God. But our value is not in pleasing people. So often we spend our lives wanting to please people. Our value is not in pleasing people, but in pleasing God. And I hope, among other things that you have heard through your time here, you will keep this in mind as you leave here. Young people, you have nothing to prove, but you have someone to please. As you leave here, you have nothing to prove, but you have somebody to please. And that's the Lord Jesus Christ. So class of 2022, spend your lives seeking to please the master, the owner of your life, the Lord Jesus Christ. Seek the Lord's well done, good and faithful servant, not the applause of men. And then truth number four is this. A clay pot is often more valuable when broken. Say, what? A clay pot is often more valuable when broken. Do you remember back in the New Testament, a lady named Mary? Mary sat at the feet of Jesus. She wanted to be around Jesus. She wanted to learn from the Master. And one day she was sitting at the feet of Jesus, and she took a clay pot that had been filled with ointment, and she broke that pot. She smashed it on the ground, and precious ointment spilled out of that clay pot. And the room was filled with a wonderful fragrance, and she used that oil to anoint and cleanse the feet of Jesus as an act of worship. What does it mean to be broken? You know what? I wish I could say to you tonight that every night in your life from here on out will be as special and wonderful as this night. I wish I could, but I can't. Because in a sin-cursed world, we have trials. We have heartache. But these struggles that we go through in our lives can make us stronger. Because it is in the brokenness that we find the true source of our strength. And it's not us, but it's God. He's the source of our strength. And so we go through difficult times. And I know many of you who are graduating tonight, you have gone through some tough times in your life. We go through those hard times, and Paul understood that. In 2 Corinthians 12:9, he said this, "My strength is made perfect. It matures, it's complete in my weakness. And when I am weak, then I'm strong." And I want to challenge all of our graduates tonight to embrace those times of brokenness. None of us want it. None of us want to go there. I didn't want my children to have to go there. I certainly don't want my grandchildren to have to go there. But all of us face those times of heartache and pain and brokenness. I've experienced brokenness in my life. And one of the toughest times has been the last year and a half for me. A year and a half ago, I almost died. I came very close to dying. I was rushed into surgery, and, you know, I was supposed to come. I was invited to come last year to speak at graduation. I couldn't come. I couldn't make the trip because in the last year and a half, I've had two major surgeries. I had sepsis. I had blood clots in my lungs and my legs, and it was tough. It was tough physically. But harder for me, it was tough emotionally and mentally and, yes, even spiritually. And after the first surgery, I couldn't preach for over 2 months. And when I came back, I sat when I preached. Then I had to have another surgery, and it took me 5 weeks to come back again. And those times come in our lives, but I want to tell you, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, I had to learn to embrace that. Why? Because when I am weak, I am strong through Christ. I'm stronger in Jesus Christ today than I think I've ever been after over 40 years in ministry. But it was learning to be willing to be broken so that I could have the power of Christ upon my life. You see, graduates, it's through brokenness, we find the source of our strength. And it's not us. It's God. And so let me challenge you, humbly walk with God. Humbly serve the Lord all the days of your life. Graduates, I need your attention, and we're about to close here. But this clay pot that I've been holding up and talking about, I bought this at Walmart this week for $1.50. It's just a cheap clay pot. But I'll tell you what, any of our graduates, if you want to give me, and you can give it to me after the graduation, you want to give me $5, you can have it. I mean, I came all the way from West Virginia. I got to make a little money on this, okay? All right? So it cost me $1.50. Do any of you want to buy it? You can buy it from me after the ceremony for $5. Anybody? Any takers? Well, that makes sense. Total sense. Why would you spend $5 on a plain old jug, clay pot that would only cost me $1.50? Well, there'd be no reason to do it unless you knew that there was a treasure inside. Now, how many of you would like to give me, this is $20 bill if you can't see it, how many would like to give me $5 for the clay pot now? I see a lot of parents. Too late. But the fact of the matter is that this clay pot, not real impressive, but there was a treasure inside. And as I said before, your lives are valuable to God because you leave here as ambassadors for Jesus Christ tonight. Ambassadors for Fayette Christian School, class of 2022. And you are so valuable to your parents, to your teachers, to your family, to your friends, but especially to God. And so in just a few moments, you will walk across this stage. You will receive a diploma. You will be a high school graduate. That will be a title that you can always say, I am a high school graduate. You will have that wonderful accomplishment. And over time, perhaps you'll receive other titles, college graduate, doctor perhaps, lawyer, teacher, husband, wife, parent. But young people, as I close, I want to challenge you tonight to add another title to your life in addition to high school graduate tonight. And that title is clay pot. Clay pot. Be a clay pot in which the Lord can fill you with his presence, because there's valuable treasure in clay pots. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this class. I pray, Lord, that you would be with each and every graduate. Lord, they are special. They are greatly loved. And Lord, what a wonderful evening this is. And I pray you would watch over them. You would protect them. Lord, you would use their lives. And Lord, from this time forward, may they be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
I knew there was going to be a treasure in the pot, so I had told him when he asked, I was going to volunteer. He said, no, it's only for the graduates. So I knew, and I thought, oh, if only you had known. Okay, well, this is like in a wedding, you may now kiss the bride. You now may have your diploma. So seniors, will you please come and line up in proper order? I will be announcing the graduates' names. Pastor Guerin will hand them the diplomas. Emily Renee Barker. Caitlin Elise Crichton. McKenna Lee Granger. Xander Douglas Ivy. Madison Morgan Riley. Megan Claire Showway Sheeter. Jackson Dale Walker. Seniors, you may now turn your tassels. It is my pleasure to present to you the 2022 graduates of Fayette Christian School. Right. All right, if you would please stand, I'll ask Pastor Michael Kahn to come and give the benediction, and then the recessional, the seniors will leave the stage, and then you are dismissed.
Let's pray. Father God, we thank you so much for your kindness to us in your Son, Jesus. And Holy Spirit, we thank you that you've comforted us with this truth, that we have your word and you speak to us clearly in your word, and you have allowed in this community there to be a place with your people where we get to treasure this reality and we see how your word touches everything. Father, we thank you for a place like Fayette Christian School. We thank you for the staff and the teachers, the administration, all who contribute, whether volunteers or those who come and participate as grandparents and aunts and uncles. We thank you for parents who all put a premium on the reality of the day and age in which we live and the need for a disciple-making academy. Father, this place can become very many different things. We ask by your grace, Father, that it would continue to be a place where people learn of Jesus, that they love Jesus, and that they go from here living for him. And though, Father, my time with this graduating class has been short and very brief, I commend them now to your church, Father. And I pray that they do go out from here as young adults, participating, joining themselves in the local body of a community of believers. This is the biggest thing you're doing in the world today. And as we've been encouraged tonight, may we see them apply themselves to that wonderful work as you do that in the building up of your church. We pray a blessing upon them and all their endeavors. We pray a blessing upon their families and this gathering here as we go from here even now. We pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen.